Hey guys and gals, I'm here with hopefully an interesting video. I want to thank all of you right off the bat for all the great support I've gotten with Lost Galaxy. I didn't think it would get the kind of traction it seems to be getting so far. I've only seen a couple complaints. They were valid complaints. I'm not gonna. It's not a perfect video, but it's been an overwhelmingly positive response. So. Thank you. Thank you very much for watching it. Thank you for enjoying it. And I definitely had fun making it. I'm just tweaking a few things real quick. I had a lot of fun making it, and I was a lot of anticipation about putting it out there. So the question, of course, now is what's next? What will I do after Lightspeed Rescue? Because that is the next one. I pitched an idea during my live stream this past Friday about me going to, there's a website called greenranger.com, and it's just take out the E's. Spell out Green Ranger, take out the E's. And it has a really nice archive of Power Ranger toys. And I have not been here in years, but I'm really glad that it's actually not just still up, but it's still active. They're still updating it. It's got everything from Mighty Morphin Season 1 up through Beast Morphers, and it even has like the other tokusatsu adaptations. There's Beetleborgs, there's Masked Riders, VR Troopers, Mystic Knights of Tyranog, which I remember the name of, but not the actual show itself. So people seem to like the idea. This may be a boring one. This is essentially what's going to be happening for the video. Me with a little face cam, which I hate using the term face cam, and me going through a bunch of Megazords and seeing if it's something I would like to buy for my collection and kind of give you guys a heads up of what might be coming someday. If you factor in, I do one of these every 8 years. I've got the rest of my life kind of mapped out for Power Rangers. So, on to Green Ranger. I know I'm doing Lightspeed Rescue, so there's no point covering that one. Time Force, I'm unsure of. So the problem is, a lot of these I have not seen in a very long time. If I've seen them at all. Time Force, I remember liking the toys of, but I haven't seen them in forever. So let's see what we have. Deluxe weapon, deluxe vehicle, standard Zord. I think I just want the deluxe swords. Deluxe Time Force Megazord. And that's a big old beefy boy. Transforms into three different modes. So the Zords. Or different modes. Instructions. Let's see. I don't like how wide his chest is. He's got really, really big holes in his hands. There are the Zords. Okay, so there are two modes. There's a mode red and a mode blue. I don't like how tiny like its forearms are. If you look on it, like I'm not sure if you can see my cursor. You got these big old shoulders, little dinky arms. And I think it's the same thing over here. It's just the shoulders and the arms are kind of more connected. That's not what I remembered at all. How about the Time Shadow Megazord? I'm getting big Max Solar Zord vibes from it. It looks like it's just a brick with little spindly arms. The arms are tiny. Oh no. I really remembered liking the Time Force Zords. Oh, this is interesting. Okay, the Quantasaurus Rex, I remember the name of. These pictures aren't great. I really thought there were more detailed shots and not just packaging. Let's check out the instructions for the Quantazord or the Quantasaurus Rex. His proportions don't look horrible. Does it interact with the Megazords at all? The other ones? Megazord mode, this mode, this lit. It doesn't? I assume the Quantasaurus was like the Ultra Zord kind of thing. Does it transform on its own? I'm really confused. It's got a walking mode, a turn mode. A morph mode? So do you even have to change it? Is this even the, like, the proper deluxe version? I'm confused. What's the control center? Oh, no, we don't care about that. Okay, so Time Force has three Zords, three Megazords, and one of them might be an ultimate that just walks on its own. Yeah, I don't know. Not sure about Time Force. Let's go to Wild Force. Action, Cycle, Morpher, Weapon, Deluxe Weapon, Deluxe Megazord. The Wild Force Megazord. I remember you. This one's not bad. It's not. So we got a bull. We got a shark. I assume it's a shark. A lion, some kind of winged thing, and a tiger, maybe? That's not bad. Its proportions are nice. It's got a little bit of goofiness to it, which I'm okay with. Who's the Predazord? Predazord is, I'm guessing, some kind of either a big cat or a wolf. I'm guessing a big cat. A hammerhead shark and a crocodile or alligator. I don't mind that one. And the Animus Megazord. Oh god, wait, is Wild Force the season that had like 15 bajillion Zords? Is that what's going on here? Oh no, the Conquistador. There's five Zords for you two. Oh no. Wild Force. Like, the Megazords aren't bad. Deluxe Red Wild Lion Zord. Oh, you're just a thing that rides. Okay. And then there's the Ultimus. What are you? That looks like the Kongazord's chest. Let's see. So it's the Kongazord's chest and head with the bull. Are there two bulls? They have different arms though. Oh. Combine three Zords and the Soul Bird. Battery operated walking action. Oh no, this one walks too. So maybe I don't want this one. Maybe this one is just some like jumbo electronic one. Oh lord. Wild Force. The only thing that will stop me from getting Wild Force is that there's another Megazord. Is that there are so many to get. Is that a giraffe? And an elk? A deer? A rhino? I don't know what you are. An eagle? That's the only thing stopping me. Is that there are so many to get, really. I don't mind their overall designs. They're not bad. Ninja Storm. Action, Tri, Triple, Cyclones, Deluxe Vehicle, Micro, Deluxe Megazord, Storm Power Megazord. I remember this one. I'm not a big fan of it. Its proportions aren't bad. The big ring thing kind of bothers me. Isn't this the one that's like, they've got like the ball gimmick? It's based on like Bokinger. They're the balls. they're the spheres. And okay, that's interesting. So the one GoBusters toy that I have is the Hercules. It's a combination between a stag beetle and another beetle. If it's a Hercules beetle, that's gonna be really bad on my part because I don't remember that. I don't know beetle names. But it's the exact same two beetle types as this one. So that's funny. This one's not bad. Its proportions are all right. It's got big arms. It's a big body. I like the head. The chest piece is kind of weird. It looks like the chest really kind of pops out. I don't hate it. Oh god, what are these? The Storm Lightning? Which doesn't seem to transform. So there's a Storm Lightning, there's a Storm Power. So maybe this is just like an action figure Megazord. Ninjacon is the Ninjor. Yeah, he's the Ninjor repaint. I'd love to get a red Ninjor, honestly. Samurai Star Lightning. What's going on here? You look weird. Includes three power spheres that combine to form Hawk Sword. Okay. And then the Storm Lightning Megazord Special Edition. Jeez. So I think this is just an act. Yeah, this is okay. So there's the big ringy guy. So that's just like an action figure that I definitely don't need. Okay. Let's see. Ninja. There's a lot of toys here. Command Megazord. Ooh, sorry. So, looking at this, I feel like this is just a big electronic toy, and perhaps the other Megazords combine to make this, because I see there's the whatever the thing was called, the whatever Megazord that looked weird. There's him. Those look like the arms to the whatever the Hercules Beatles thing were. So maybe they all combine to make this, and this is just a version that doesn't transform. That's my guess. And is that it? Okay. Not horrible. Definitely not a priority though. Dino Thunder, I don't remember anything about toy wise. Dinolux Cycle, Deluxe Vehicles, Oxygen Control, Deluxe Megazord. The Thundersaurus Megazord. I can't say I'm a fan of it. And I don't know why. It's goofy looking, but so is the Megazord from Dino Charge. And I like those a lot. I think they're the right balance of goofy. I don't like the tail arm. Does it sp looks like it spins. And there's a Triceratops, so there's a Pterodactyl. I'm not a fan of that one. It's the Blizzard Force. It's mainly a repaint. It looks like it has. I see the Pterodactyl. I see the Tyrannosaurus, and it's got a new Zord for the arm. So that bothers me. The Stegazord looks okay. It's got some nice proportions. I don't know. I'm not liking these. Ooh, the Mesodon. I don't like this one. It's a chariot being pulled by you. Dino Thunder might be one that I for sure skip. Are there any more? Command Center truck, vehicles, weapons, Zord set, jumbo power, dumbo, doobah. Yep. Dino Thunder is one that I'm not looking forward to. The next two, however, I remember watching Piaw's videos for SPD and Mystic Force, however many years ago, and I remember liking them both quite a bit. So let's check out SPD. I actually checked these out already during my stream, so yeah, I've already seen these, and oh, that boy looks great. I like his proportions. It's a big, chunky boy, but it's chunky all over. I like that it has lights and sounds. Omega Megazord. I love this one. I love that the Megazord can ride it like a motorcycle. You have to take its legs apart to lock them into different ways, but it's a neat gimmick. I forgot that it actually combines with the Megazord, so that's cool to see. The Supreme Megazord. I like it. I like its proportions. It's got a weapon mode. That's interesting. I'm curious, what's the Delta Enforcer? It's a weapon. That is a weapon. Okay. And I know there is a like command base. Collections, the collectors, SPD, SPD. Here comes a Yai. Ooh, I'm going to bed after I make this. Delta Command Megazord. I like you. I like you. You're a good one. And is that it? I think that might be it. Yes. Okay. So yeah, SPD, depending on cost for like trying to find these now, I would love to do SPD. There's not a lot of Zords from it, so it would be a, I think, a relatively short video. Mystic Force, I remember there's a fair bit. I think that's like from Magi Ranger. The Titan Megazord. Let's see you. I like the Titan. I remember this one. I like that there's all individual like warrior modes for all the Zords. And then they have a dragon mode. I forgot about the dragon. Centaurus. So it has like the not released thing next to it. Now I know PR reviewed it, so I'm wondering if he reviewed the Magi Ranger version. Cause I do like that one. It becomes a centaur and it's like a wolf stuff. So okay. The Steer Durgon. Not bad. Also a centaur mode, which is interesting. So we had two centaurs. The Solar Streak Megazord. That's a big old train boy right there. Okay. Seems rim to have a train for a bunch of like mystic animal kind of things, but whatever. Role play Super Power Rangers. I'm sorry, guys. I wanted to do this earlier and I got distracted. And I want to get this made so I can upload it tomorrow. Hopefully. I'm not seeing any more Megazords. A lot of stuff. Okay, so Mystic Force is definitely a maybe. I may have to track down some Magi Ranger stuff if it's not released in the States. SPD is. Oh, I want SPD. Operation Overdrive. So, from my understanding, Operation Overdrive is like the turning point when Bandai of America stopped just importing Megazords. They started making their own. Transforming Megazords. I'm guessing these aren't the deluxe ones. That looks really cheap. Going to hope that there's better ones. Deluxe Megazords right there. The Drive Max Megazord. Looks okay. It doesn't look like the legs can have any kind of like separations. It looks like it might just be a brick. I don't hate the Zords. I'm intrigued by it. We have the dual drive, which looks okay. Those look like rail bits to me, but I think it's just the Zords themselves. I don't like the weird spindly like bulldozer type arm. And then we have another dual drive Megazord. Why are there two dual drive Megazords? And why are they so different? This one lights up and has lights and sounds. I'm gonna have to research those. Why are there two dual drive Megazords? Let's see, do we have any more Megazords? More Megazords. More. Is that it? Oh, wait. Oh. We got the Battlefleet Megazord. That looks very busy. I wish there was a better look at the robot mode, but the vehicle mode looks really neat. It looks like there's a lot of stuff going on with it. I like it based on the small bit that I can see. And I'm assuming that's it. I'm assuming that's like the Ultra Zord. Okay. Operation Overdrive is a maybe. Let's go to Jungle Fury. You know, I'm not gonna look at all of these because some of these I know for sure. We're not gonna go down that road. So let's check out Jungle Fury. Animalize, Animorphin, Micro, Cycle. There's a lot more toys in this one. Are going to ignore the Transfer Megazord. There's the Jungle Pride Megazord. That looks honestly not bad. I like its proportions. It's got three Zords, which I think is becoming more of like a standard thing. The Jungle Master. Another gorilla. I don't know what you are. What the heck is that thing? My eyes are watering. What is that? That's some kind of elk? Something? Motorized Thunder Punch. Oh, see, they all have these motorized gimmicks that I don't think I will actually like to have in person. Deluxe action, hand gear, soft action, adventure vehicles, transforming Megazord again. There have to be more deluxe Megazords on this. Multiple deluxe Megazord, the Rhino Steel Megazord. Looks all right. That's definitely a Rhino. He's gonna have a big horn with the sword, and it's a Disney Store exclusive, so that might be a little bit of a challenge to find. It's all right. I don't hate it. The Ultimate Megazord set. What all came in there? Ooh. I don't know who's included that's not from, like, the other sets. I recognize some of these. Figure sets, DX vehicle, DX deluxe, transforming deluxe. Okay, so that's it for there. Jungle Fury's not horrible, but I'm not wooed like I am with, like, SPD. RPM, I don't remember a lot of. I think it has the Totem Pole Megazord. Deluxe Formula Megazords? There's the Totem Pole. This one I'm not a huge fan of. Maybe it'll look better, like, out of the box. Based on just the few pictures I've seen, I'm not sold. I need to look up some video reviews and actually see if I like these more. The Valvemex Megazord looks okay. He looks really lanky. And of course, at this point, I have to compare these to the Sentai versions. And I don't know what those are gonna look like. I ideally want to have the best looking version of the toy, of the robot, for my own personal collection. My nose is suddenly runny. That's great. These aren't bad, but I'm going to have to compare them to the Sentai versions and see which looks better. These guys look like they're kind of stretched out a little bit, and I'm not sure if that's how it's going to be for their appearance in the show versus the original toys from Japan. The American versions aren't selling me just yet. Command Center, Ranger Cycles, Roleplay, Adventure, Vehicles, Retro, Vehicles, Turbo Megazords. What are you? Turbo High Octane Megazord. Which looks like the same thing as the other, just it's a Disney Store exclusive. So I don't know what's going on there. And there's another Valvemax. So Disney Store exclusive. See, I need to compare, like, what's the difference between the Disney Store exclusives versus the regular release. Are there improvements? Are there cheapened versions? That's when they brought Mighty Morphin back for the season. Or for... They brought it back with, like, stupid effects. And I hated it. Samurai, I think I remember. Battle Eye, Cyclone, Deluxe. Look, Megazord. We got the Samurai Megazord. That one I know I would want the Sentai release, so that changes everything. I would have to get the Sentai version of everything if I want them to all combine like they're supposed to. So this is basically no good. Oh, it's another Samurai Megazord. And I know that they released the Japanese version in America for like a special kind of deal. But I would have to track down the Sentai versions for all of these if I got them. The bowl's not bad. I'm getting Deluxe Taurozord, or Defender Taurozord vibes from that. The Gigazord. Looks okay. I don't know. And also, you know, it depends on if I've actually watched the shows that these are based off from. You know, it could be possible that I have no attachment to anything from Samurai, or was it? Wasn't Ghost Siger. Ghost Siger was, like, I think the next season. I don't know all the Sentai names. It's possible I might watch the Sentai this is from, like it, and want to get toys from it. I say because I'm probably never going to watch the Power Rangers version of these. That's a big old gift set. Look at that. Wow. So, yeah, that one's not horrible, but I would have to get the Sentai releases, which makes it obviously more expensive. Great Ghost Size. So this is Gosiger, or Gosiger, whichever one it is pronounced. Deluxe Megazord, the Gosai Great Megazord. See, I don't know how this compares to the Sentai release. It looks okay. There's the Ultimate. Yeah, which is just Gosai's face. I forgot the whole card gimmick. I forgot what that does. And are there any more? Oh, they were doing an Alpha 5 and Zordon? What's that? Don't I have that Alpha? Maybe not. I don't know. Anyway. Megazord figures. We're not going to dabble with those. Those are just actual figures. Are there any more deluxe Megazords? Legacy Megazord. Okay, so that's it for that one. Are there just two? There have to be more. Super Mega Force. That's the one that had the, I think it's Gokiger, where it had, like, the pirate theme stuff. I think. And at that point, I think I would just go for the Sentai, honestly. Legendary Megazord. Yep, there's the pirate themes. I don't hate the pirate themed. I don't love it. I'm sure it's way better in context. See, I don't like just having a random, just like a tail drill arm kind of thing going. I don't know, like, I don't want to just buy whatever I can find to just do a video on. I would like to have things that I want to have in my actual collection. And I want the best versions of these Zords. So, depending on how they compare to the Sentai release, that's what it all comes down to. You know, whether there's not many differences. I think I'm done with that one. So, yeah, I think that's really it. I'm not going to be doing Dino Charge because I have the toys from Curiger, and I forgot if I've said this video or not, so I may be repeating myself. I have most of the mecha from Curiger, which is the Sentai version, Dino Charge, and Super Dino Charge is based off of. I want to do the same format with those as I do for my Power Ranger videos, just covering the Japanese release. So it'll be technically Dino Charge, or whatever season that counts as, but it also, it'll be Curiger. I don't have anything from Ninja Steel, or whatever its Sentai counterpart is, so, from what I remember, let me double check, see which one this was. Yeah, didn't like this one. I didn't care for the gimmick of just having the red mecha or the red Zord just riding in a chair. I didn't care for that one too much. And that one, I remember the Sentai release looked so much better than the Bandai of American one, the Bandai of America one. So that's probably not going to happen. Beast Morphers, I'm not going to do because I want to do the same thing with GoBusters as I'm doing for Curiger. I just have one of the Megazords from Beast Morphers / GoBusters. Same thing with that one. So at the end of all of this, I for sure want to do SPD, Mystic Force, Curiger, and GoBusters. So those are the ones that I would love to do, permitted that it's not super expensive to track down the figures. Some of these are pretty old toys, and they can go for a lot of money. The rest of them, it's really up in the air. Dino Thunder didn't really work for me. Wild Force has a lot of Zords. Time Force has 3 Megazords, unless I missed one. So that's appealing, just from a collecting standpoint. That's less to find. And the rest, I don't know. I do have Beetleborg toys that I kind of want to dig out and do videos on. So, but yeah, that's kind of where my head is at in terms of what's next Power Ranger wise. I got a question just 10 minutes before I made this video, and I was like, I need to go ahead and put this out now. So I hope this answers some of your questions about what might happen next. I don't know. I don't have any kind of time frame on when these will be happening, but yeah. That's where we are. I thank you guys for watching. I certainly do appreciate if you've made it this far. Thank you again for all of the love that I've gotten for Lost Galaxy. I hope I get the same kind of love for Lightspeed Rescue, and I hope it doesn't take 8 years to make. As always, if you liked this video and you want to see more, I got random things all around. I don't know how this orientation is going to line up, whether it's mirrored or not, so I got a Patreon button somewhere up there. I have videos you can watch either there or there. I don't know where they are. And or I have a subscribe button up there, and then a Patreon's down there. Have a great evening and or day. I will see you around, and take care.